Hello to all students, I hope you are doing fine. Today we are going to discuss a life cycle of eucestoid. Eucestoids are usually known as tapeworm. They belong to phylum Platyhelminthes and class Cestoidea. And the true tapeworm, which belongs to subclass Eucestoda. If we look at the meaning of Eucestoda, Eu mean true and Cestoda mean girdle, a shape which is girdle-like. These animals are usually known as tapeworm. First of all, we are going to look at the structure, external body structure of tapeworms. Tapeworms are huge animals which are very long in length, usually up to 25 meter length. So first of all, I am going to emphasize on the diagram of a tapeworm. This is a tapeworm which is very long. This tapeworm has three body region. Then at the anterior end of the body, there is a head-like structure which is known as scolex. This region of the body contain suckers and hooks which helps the animals to attach to the surface of the small intestine. Beneath the scolex, which is head region, there is a region which is known as neck. That is the growing region of the animal. And after neck, there is a long thread-like structure, tape-like structure, which is known as strobila. This strobila contain small transverse constrictions, as you can see in these diagrams. These constrictions make the body into tiny segments. These tiny segments are known as proglottids, which collectively called strobila. And if there are many strobila, we called it strobili. The body of the tapeworm, which is strobila, can be divided into three main parts. Number one, just behind the neck, there is immature strobila. Immature strobila usually do not have reproductive organs, and they are developing reproductive organ. Just a little bit farther from the immature strobila, there is a region start which is known as mature strobila. In this region of mature strobila, the proglottids, which are the segments of the body, they contain mature reproductive organs, male and female both. That is why this region is known as mature strobila. And the last portion of the strobila is known as gravid strobila. Why this is called gravid? Because it is full of eggs. Gravid means pregnant, full of eggs, just like a bag of eggs. So that is why the last portion of the body is known as gravid strobila. The outermost layer of the tapeworm is known as tegument. Tegument helps to protect the body from the enzymes of the digestive system of the host, and also absorb nutrients from the digestive system of the host. There is no specialized digestive system, circulatory system, excretory system, and other body function system. There are very incomplete systems present in the body of the nervous system, though is present, which runs along the length of the body, and there are some ganglia which is present on the anterior region or in the head region of the scolex, which helps to navigate the animal. Because these animals live in the small intestine, the digested food already present in the digestive system, which they absorb from the surrounding medium. So there is no need for digestive system, and also there is no need for other circulatory or excretory or some other body functions, because everything can be maintained by the general body surface. So their body is just like a tape. So that is why they are usually known as tapeworm, and they can reach up to the length of 25 meter. Now we are going to discuss the internal structure of the tapeworm. So what I have done, that I made a diagram, detailed diagram of each part of the body of the tapeworm. First of all, we are going to look at the internal structure of the scolex. Scolex is the anterior region of the body. So this is the anterior region of the body, which is known as scolex. Scolex is a head region. Usually it contains ganglion, which act has a brain, and on the outer surface of the scolex there are suckers. As you can see, suckers are the adhesive organs with which animal these suckers helps the animal to attach to the surface of the small intestine of its host. Some tapeworm also contain a crown-like structure which is known as rostilum. Rostilum contain hooks, as you can see over here. These are hooks, red color, in red color. These hooks also helps to penetrate and attach with the surface of the internal lining of the small intestine. When they attach with the surface of the small intestine and their body, which is segmented body known as strobila, that is also move in the length of the whole length of the small intestine, where they can absorb and excrete the nutrients and waste products. Just below or posterior to the scolex, there is a region which is known as neck region. As I already mentioned you there, neck region is a growing region, just like your nail. Your nail has a growing region just behind the or the base of the nail. When nail grows upward, your nail grows and you clip it or you cut the nail. Just like that, their body grows unlimitedly from the neck region, and their proglottids break off from the terminal last distal portion of the body. The segments of the body of the tapeworm are known as proglottid. Usually tapeworms are monoecious. They contain both reproductive organs. Male and female reproductive organs are present in the same body. So I have taken a proglottid from the body of the tapeworm, which is mature proglottid. It means that it has developed male and female reproductive organ in the same organism. So this is a proglottid, which is mature. It contains both male and female reproductive organs. First of all, we are going to look at the male reproductive organs. So as you can see in this diagram, the blue spots, blue points, as you can see in this diagram, are known as testes. These are testes dispersed in the whole proglottid. These are interconnected with small membranes, which ends into a duct, which is known as sperm duct. Sperm duct helps to move sperms from testes to the reproductive organ, which is known as cirrus. At the terminal portion, at the last portion of that sperm duct, there is a reproductive organ, which is known as cirrus, which acts as a copulatory organ and helps to transfer sperms from one tapeworm to the other tapeworm. Now, if we look at the female reproductive organ of the tapeworm, female reproductive organ consists of ovaries. There are two ovaries present on the lateral side of the body of the proglottid. As you know, that ovary helps in the production of eggs. As eggs are produced in the ovary, eggs are transported into a duct which is known as oviduct. Oviduct transports the eggs into a region which is known as oocyte. Oocyte is a special region where eggs are deposited, where eggs are fertilized and capsule is formed around the egg. There is a yolk gland just nearby the oocyte, which produces yolk, which is gradually stored in the fertilized egg. And also there is a associated gland which is known as Mehle's gland, which aids in the formation of the capsule around the egg after fertilization. Usually the tapeworm are monoecious. They do self-fertilization, but the rule is that they try to cross-fertilize each with each other so that a hybrid vigor embryo or embryos and adult are produced, which are better to adopt in diverse or parasitic conditions of the environment. So for this reason, two tapeworms come close to each other. There is an opening on the surface of the proglottid which is known as genital pore. The two tapeworm come across each other, their genital pore come across each other. The first the one tapeworm become male and the other become female at the same time. The first one becomes female and the second one becomes male. So they do cross fertilization. First tapeworm releases the sperms with help of cirrus into the second tapeworm. Sperms are transferred into genital pore, which are then transported into vagina, and vagina opens into a wider region of the vagina, which is known as seminal receptacle. Seminal receptacle stores the sperms of the other tapeworm. As sperms are stored in this सेमिलर रिसेप्टेकल मेच्योर. यूजली द रूल इज दैट मेल गेमीट्स मेच्योर फर्स्ट एंड देन फीमेल गेमीट्स मेच्योर लेटर. सो एज सून एज मेल स्पर्म्स आर स्टोर्ड इन द सेमिनल रिसेप्टेकल एंड देन एग्स आर प्रोड्यूस्ड एंड मेच्योर्ड इन द ओवरी, देन दीज एग्स आर ट्रांसफर्ड इन टू द ऊ टाइप वेयर एग्स आर फर्टिलाइज्ड. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, योक इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई योक ग्लैंड इज डिपॉजिटेड इन द एग. And after that, Mehli's gland helps in the formation of the capsule, which is protective layer around the egg. Once egg is mature, fertilized, contains yolk, and has been encapsulated, these eggs are transferred into a structure known as uterus. The uterus is blind-ended. All the eggs, when mature and encapsulated, when they are stored in the uterus, usually the number of these eggs is 80,000. Then reproductive organs of the male and the female, both organ degenerate and whole proglotted, only contain uterus, which is full of eggs. That proglotted is known as gravid proglotted. Now this is the gravid proglotted. It contain uterus, which is full of eggs, which is about 80,000 eggs in one proglotted, which has an opening known as genital pore, and this whole proglotted is known as gravid, means full of eggs proglotted. So in this way, there is a external body structure which is very simple and internal body structure which is usually contain reproductive organs, male and female reproductive organs. And now the most important thing of the tapeworm is their life cycle. So now we are going to discuss the life cycle of a tapeworm. So let's start with the adult tapeworm. This is a adult tapeworm which has been attached to the surface of the small intestine of host. So I just want to let you know that as parasites are of different types, ectoparasite which live outside the body, endoparasite which live inside the body. Similarly, hosts are also of different types. Human is the definitive host of the tapeworm, without which their life cycle cannot be completed. And usually in definitive host, a parasite completes its sexual reproduction. So this whole reproduction process takes place in the body of the human, in the small intestine of human. That is why human is the definitive host. So inside the body of the definitive host, which is human, sexual reproduction process of sexual reproduction when it's completed, proglotted, which has been matured, gravid, has been completed, it cuts off from the body, as you can see in this diagram. It cuts off, breaks off from the body of the tapeworm. This is proglotted, which is full of eggs. This is known as gravid proglotted. From small intestine, this gravid proglotted travels through large intestine and reaches into the rectum. As you know, the rectum is a place where feces, undigested waste material of the body, is stored. From there, from where in the rectum, there is an opening is produced in the surface of the proglotted, from where eggs are released into the feces. When eggs are released into the feces, as you know that egg contain a capsule which contain eggs, and this capsule also contains six hooks which are chitinous, which helps to attach the egg to the surface of any material. So this condition is known as oncosphere. Oncosphere is a egg containing structure which has a capsule which contain six hooks. That is why we called it hexacanth. This hexacanth oncospheres are present in the feces of human body. Now these feces, when a human body goes into the toilet, the feces are released into the toilet, and from toilet, with help of water, they travel from different places into the grazeland, into the field of the where cows graze, where cattle graze, or some other animals can graze, from where these eggs can be transported into different places. Now this hexacanth oncosphere has been reached into the pasture land, where they can attach with the surface of the plants or the surface of the grass, where an animal, which is cattle, which is also known as intermediate host, which is grazing. As the grazer, which is a cow, grazes in the field or eats the fodder or eats the grass, the eggs are attached with the surface of the plants, reaches into the body of the cattle, which is their intermediate host. When these eggs reaches into the digestive system of the cow, the enzymes of the digestive system breaks the capsule of the oncosphere from where egg is hatched and it becomes a larva. These larva penetrate from small intestine and enter into the skeletal muscle of the body. When they reach into the skeletal muscle of the body, they make a cyst, fluid filled cyst, which is known, this stage is known as cysticercus, and this stage usually takes place in the muscles, front muscles, belly muscle, leg muscle, any muscle of the body, in the form of a small fluid filled cyst. That is why in this condition these larvae are known as bladder worm. These bladder worms is a condition in which larva and cyst in the muscles of the host, which is a second host, which is intermediate host, and sleeps for a long period of time. Now what happens, this animal is slaughtered by some animal, some slaughtered by some butcher to sell the beef, to sell the meat of this animal. When this animal is eaten by some other human being and the meat is not properly cooked, like if you do barbecue, the meat is not properly cooked, then what happens, this cysted larva enters into the digestive system of the human body, where it multiplies and grows into a new adult tapeworm. It develops a scolex which contain suckers, with the help of these suckers and hooks it can attach to the surface of the small intestine. This encysted larva develops into new tapeworm which contain hooks and suckers with the help of which it attaches to the small surface and it becomes into new tapeworm. Now this, in this way, whole life cycle of the tapeworm has been completed. Now I have summarized this whole life cycle into a different way so that you can easily understand and easily remember it. First of all, adult tapeworm. Adult tapeworm is Tinea rhynchus saguinatus, lives in the small intestine of human, which is the definitive host, where it produces reproductive organs in a structure known as proglotid, which is contain male and female reproductive organs. Proglotids produces eggs which are oncospheres, contain hooks, six hooks. Oncospheres are released to the feces of the human body, and feces reaches from with help of water to different grasslands where cattle graze on these grasses and plants, and this larva reaches into the body of the cattle, and from cattle they reach into the digestive system of the cattle, from where they enter small intestine. Enzymes of the digestive system breaks the oncosphere and release the larva. Larva penetrates the small intestine and reaches to the bloodstream, and from bloodstream it reaches to the skeletal muscle of the animal, which is their second host, which is known as intermediate host, where they will live some life, which is usually asexual reproduction. In the skeletal muscle they form a cyst like structure which is known as cysticercus, which is known as bladder worm, in which is a fluid filled chamber in which larva become dormant and remains there for some period of the life of their life cycle. When a man slaughter the cow, eat the meat of not properly cooked, and the larva will be transported into the digestive system of the human body, where it will regrow into an adult tapeworm and start to living in the body of the human small intestine, and in this way life cycle has been completed. So that's all for today. I hope it makes sense, and we'll see you in the next lecture. Until then, bye.